Welcome back. A quick look at the Asian markets. Now they're reversing off the morning highs. In fact, the Nikkei as well as the Kospi in the red, the Hang Seng as well as the Shanghai, both of them have opened about 0.5% lower. And as a result of that, the SGX Nifty 2, which was earlier indicating a start in the tune of around 6 to 7 points in the green, has now turned into the red, flattened out a little bit. So the Asian market's not doing too well, giving up early gains. But the key triggers for our markets, of course, will be earnings. And staying with the earnings expected today, Abhishek joins us to tell us what to expect from HDFC Life and ICICI Pru, both the insurance companies. Abhishek.
Good morning, Mangalam. So, HDFC Life is expected to give a strong result. The total first-year premium has grown by 37% YOY. So, they will continue to see an uptrend in the market share. Individual non-single premium is seeing a decline in growth. However, going momentum on protection business, that will be very positive for the company. So, if you look at the value of new business margin, that would be at 24% for the 9 months period. And that's an uptick of close to 200 basis points on a YOY basis, and the value of new business should be at 960 crore for the 9 month period, an uptick of 23% on a YOY basis. You look at the breakup of the segment, individual segment is expected to report a strong number in terms of the single premium, which is expected to grow at 186%, while group premium can grow at 38 and 263 based on the single premium and renewal premium. Coming on to ICICI Life, that's expected to report a weak set of numbers. Market share in individual policies will decline because they have already declined in Q3. First year premium should grow at 10.2%, but if you look at the breakup, the individual segment is expected to record a degrowth or decline in growth YOY, both in single and the non-single premium. So high ULIP exposure at 80% likely have impacted the growth in Q3, and growth in premium mostly led from group policies. One key thing to watch will be the value of new business margin. Anything above 17% will be positive. Back to you.
All right, and Abhishek, thanks a lot for that. In fact, that is the preview coming in from both HDFC as well as ICICI Pru. But move away from insurance to wires. Anisha, what to look for in Havells Q3 results?
Well, Havells actually surprised us positively in the last couple of quarters, but the management has been saying that don't extrapolate these numbers. There was one off, but we're still expecting a steady quarter from the company. So the revenue is expected to jump up by 15% on a year-on-year basis. The margins, however, might deplete given the product mix as well as the operational leverage. So the margins might come down by 70 basis points to 12.8%, and the profits are seen flat at 192 crores versus 194 crores. But do remember there was an exceptional gain last year of 21 crores, and that is the reason why the profits look flat. Now to talk about the various segments, the growth is expected to come in from the switchgear, cable and the ECD segment of the company. So we're expecting a 15 to 20% growth when it comes to the switchgear business as well as the ECD segment. However, the cables might grow by 10 to 15%. Important to see how Lloyd's business do because that was a dampener last time. So we'll watch out for the management commentary on Lloyd as well.
All right, Anisha, thanks a lot for that. Slip into yet another short break. Come back, get you a check on the cues to watch from the futures and options space.